Hello and welcome to Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi. The ICC Cricket World Cup starts 30th May in England and Wales. The quadrennial event is coming back to what is officially known as the home of cricket this summer after as many as 20 years. In this age of T20s, experts are telling people to expect a run fest in what are likely to be batting-friendly conditions throughout the tournament. In the recent history of ODI cricket, England has broken the record of highest totals twice. The format of World Cup is same as the one used in 1999, where every team plays every team and the top four from the table qualify for the World Cup. That makes it even more competitive and engaging. Along with England and Australia, India too start off as one of the favourites. The upcoming World Cup contains a blend of both new and old talent. While for some, it will be a swan song and celebration of their careers as they make their last appearance. For many others, it will be their first World Cup. In today's in-depth, we will dwell on the history of what happens to be the cricket's biggest festival. Some of the top players who are expected to be in the spotlight of the world cricket. The 2019 ICC Cricket World Cup is the 12th edition of the Cricket World Cup, scheduled to be hosted by England and Wales from 30th May to 14th of July 2019. The first match will be played at the Oval, while the final will be played at Lord's. It is the fifth time that the Cricket World Cup will be held in England and Wales, following the 1975, 1979, 1983 and 1999 World Cup. With just a few days to go for this blockbuster, here is how the teams have been shaping up for this big event.
With less than 2 weeks to go for the ICC World Cup 2019 opener, teams are busy regrouping for preparations. 10 teams are taking part, with each team playing the other 9 once, and the top 4 at the end of the group phase progressing to the semi-finals. Given the increase of the test playing nations from 10 to 12, with the admission of Ireland and Afghanistan in June 2017, it will be the first World Cup to be contested without all the test playing nations being present. Besides the host England, India, Pakistan, South Africa, New Zealand, Australia, Bangladesh, West Indies, Sri Lanka and Afghanistan will play the tournament. Afghanistan won the qualifiers, defeating the West Indies in the final. Both teams qualified, while Zimbabwe, despite hosting the qualifying tournament, failed to reach the final and will miss the World Cup for the first time since 1983. Recently appointed full member Ireland will also miss the World Cup for the first time since 2007, and for the first time ever, no associate nation will be participating in the World Cup. In this World Cup, the group stage format is a round robin, where all 10 teams play each other once in a single group. This means 45 matches will be played, with each team playing 9 matches. The top 4 will progress to the knockout stage. A similar format was previously used in 1992 Cricket World Cup. In this year's World Cup, the 10-team tournament will give teams no chance for errors, with the league format ensuring that they have to stay on top of the race to qualify for the semi-finals. According to the International Cricket Council, hosts England with the home advantage are probably the strongest contenders. Although England are the inventors of the cricket, they have failed to lift the prestigious trophy even once. ICC said with batting firepower, they can back their lineup to chase down most scores. However, a one-dimensional fast bowling attack is a concern that England needs to address. ICC, however, says India is not too far behind England. Virat Kohli's men have left behind the nightmare of the 2017 Champions Trophy final and made significant changes to the squad. India not only has the two best world's ODI batsmen, but also the best death bowler Jasprit Bumrah. It's no surprise the team has lost just a bilateral ODI series since 2017. The aggression of Kohli and the calmness of the Dhoni will form a lethal combination. The Black Caps are a bit underrated, but they never fail to make a mark. New Zealand play the home matches in conditions somewhat similar to English conditions. This makes them strong contenders for the trophy. And finally, South Africa, that always start as favourites, but have so far been disappointed. This year also, they have a tremendous side. The last World Cup in England in 1999 was held between 14th May to 20th June, and the weather and pitches proved to be a factor, at least in games at Leeds, Southampton and Old Trafford. However, this time with the matches to begin from May 30th, will allow the tournament to be played in more summer-like conditions. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Cricket is a game with a mix of everything. Batting, bowling, fielding. Each of the three spheres are significant in making the match look for the sought-after batsmen, bowlers and fielders. In this report, we will have a look at the top five batsmen, bowlers and fielders in the world.
The game of cricket has escalated to a whole another level now and is more intense than ever. For long, the gentleman's game has been dubbed a batsman game. It is true to an extent because we see scores as high as 600 in a test, 400 in an ODI and 200 in a T20.
Well, you know, when we talk about main players, there are so many main players. I mean, Virat Kohli is your top batsman in the world. He has proved in every part of the world that he could score on the pitches, even on the difficult pitches. Then, obviously, I'm going to miss AB de Villiers, who was, to me, you know, till recent, he was the top player, even better than Virat Kohli in one-day and T20 scenario. But unfortunately, he's not there. But Warner has come back. Smith has come back. Joe Root is going to prove himself. Being a captain of England, he is favourite to win this World Cup for his country for the first time in the history.
India, New Zealand, England, Australia and South Africa are some quality batting sides. It should not come as a surprise to anyone if batsmen from any of these countries set the 2019 World Cup on fire. Top 5 batsmen in the world cricket are Virat Kohli. He is the best batsman in the world cricket right now in all the three formats. He is ranked number one in tests. Kohli recently became the second fastest to score 24 test centuries, achieving the fantastic feat in 123 innings next to Sir Don Bradman. Virat scores his runs in tests at a strike of almost 60. His average 54.66 in tests and 58.21 in ODIs. He is known to rotate the strike more than any player and is one of the fittest players in this current Indian team. Then, Kane Williamson, one of the best captains in the world cricket at the moment. He is the fulcrum of the New Zealand batsmen and is an excellent batsman across all the three formats. Williamson is usually at his best when it comes to tests. Steve Smith, the former captain of the Australian team, is serving a ban alongside David Warner. He has been out of the international action for more than 6 months and is still on the number two position in the ICC test rankings. Smith is an impact player who likes to play a long innings every time he goes out to bat. Joey Root, the skipper of the England test team, is a threat to any team in any given conditions. Root is a fantastic player of the spin and an even better player of the swinging ball. Root is very strong on the off side of the field. He is an ideal batsman in the ODI and test format. He is one of the very few batsmen who possesses the talent to play according to the situation. Fifth is David Warner, the former vice-captain of the Australian team. He was given the post for a reason, and that was because of his exploits with the bat. Warner is an elegant left-handed batsman who can accelerate in no time and score boundaries at his own will.
I would be looking at Kedar Jadhav's role is going to be huge. I hope he gets fit fast because he is the one who can bat lower down, takes the pressure. If you have a very good stand-up, then his role is to just come out and hit. For that role, Hardik Pandya is a big contender for me. The way he played in IPL, his bowling might be under a bit of pressure because if the conditions are not seeming, he might struggle. Spinners, again, Kuldeep is somebody I'm banking on because he's still some kind of mystery bowler. But up top. If nobody has ever won the World Cup, if the openers have not performed. So openers hold the key for the World Cup. If your opening stand gets you going, then obviously you'll reach 350 plus. Then you always have a chance.
Gone are the days when the likes of Wasim Akram, Waqar Yunus, Brett Lee and Dale Steyn instill fear in the batsmen. Nowadays, fast bowlers are more content on containing the batsmen rather than going for wickets. Five best fast bowlers in the world at the moment are Kagiso Rabada. Rabada was a regular 137 km per hour bowler until he stepped up his game against England in 2017 when he started delivering around 147 km per hour. Jasprit Bumrah. Fastest delivery recorded was 148.1 km per hour, played against Pakistan. Mitchell Stark, Trent Bolt and James Anderson. Top 5 world all-rounders are Rashid Khan from Afghanistan, Shakib Al Hasan from Bangladesh, Mohammad Nabi from Afghanistan, Mohammad Hafiz from Pakistan, Mitchell Santner from New Zealand. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
The countdown for the world's biggest sporting event has begun. 10 top cricket-playing nations will battle it out in England to win the most coveted cup of the year, the ICC Cricket World Cup. As the best teams in the world cricket prepare to meet for the world's biggest cricketing extravaganza, we take you down the memory lane to take a look at the winners and losers of the past Cricket World Cups. Take a look at the Cricket World Cup.
The International Cricket Championship or the Cricket World Cup is the most awaited and most watched sporting events in the world. The first World Cup was organized in England in June 1975. The first one-day international cricket match was played only 4 years earlier. The matches consisted of 60 overs for each team, played during daytime in traditional form with the players wearing cricket whites and using red cricket balls. 8 teams took part in the first tournament. They included Australia, England, India, New Zealand, Pakistan and the West Indies. The 6 test-playing nations at the time together with Sri Lanka and a composite team from East Africa. South Africa was banned from international cricket at that time due to apartheid. The West Indies won the first World Cup, beating Australia by 17 runs. West Indies went on to win the next edition of the tournament in 1979 as well. This edition was also held in England. The format remained unchanged with 8 teams participating. These were England, India, Australia, Pakistan, West Indies, New Zealand, Sri Lanka and Canada. There was no team from Africa in this edition as East Africa failed to qualify for the tournament. West Indies beat England in the final by 92 runs that was held the home of cricket, the Lord's Cricket Stadium at London. The third edition in 1983 was once again hosted by England. While the rules of the games were modified, the format had 8 teams divided into 2 groups of 4 teams each. By this stage, Sri Lanka had become a test-playing nation and Zimbabwe qualified in the tournament for the first time. In 1983, World Cup had some dramatic cricketing moments, with underdogs like India and Zimbabwe upsetting biggies West Indies and Australia. India were crowned champions after they upset the West Indies by 43 runs in a dramatic final. India scored only 183 runs, but a brilliant bowling effort ensured that they bundled out the West Indies for just 140 runs.
Well, ICC World Cup, we all know it all started with 75 and with just an experiment that, you know, yes, whether we can come back to the, you know, US style baseball or kind of, you know, games where we could sell more. And then the carry packer has taken it to the new dimensions. But ever since 83, I think that was the changing, I would say, time when India won this World Cup, because by virtue of the largest, you know, country in the sense, in terms of population, I think we changed the entire concept of ODI. Now there is more money, there is more eyeballs to this kind of cricket, and test cricket has taken a back seat and we have, you know, seeing a new era of cricket which also includes T20.
After the 1983 edition, the World Cup finally moved outside England to India and Pakistan for the first time in 1987. The contest saw the number of overs per side reduced to 50. 8 teams qualified for the fourth edition of the tournament. Australia were crowned winners of this edition after beating England by 7 runs in the final. The fifth edition of the World Cup was jointly hosted by Australia and New Zealand in 1992. It was an edition of many firsts. The tournament saw the introduction of coloured clothing, white balls, black side screens and matches under floodlights. South Africa became the ninth team in the tournament after getting readmitted to the International Cricket Council, 21 years after it was excluded over apartheid. The edition also saw a new winner, with Pakistan lifting the trophy, beating England in the finals by 22 runs. The World Cup returned to the subcontinent for the second time in 1996 Cricket World Cup. While India and Pakistan hosted the tournament for the second time, it was the first time for Sri Lanka. The number of participating countries increased to 12, with 9 full members: Australia, England, India, New Zealand, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, South Africa, West Indies and Zimbabwe, and Kenya, Netherlands and United Arab Emirates as 3 associate countries. Asian teams continued their dominance in this edition as well, with Sri Lanka beating a strong Australian team by 7 wickets to win their maiden ICC World Cup title.
I mean, the format keeps on changing, the rules have changed a lot, the pinch hitting came in, they had a rule for 15 overs, now it's back to 10 overs, there are 2 power plays, and the last 10 overs, one fielder extra is outside, before it was less. So I think a lot of permutations and combinations, headaches for captains. DRS is something very interesting, how to use it, how not to. So it'll be very interesting to watch how captains approach it. You know, captains became redundant for a while in one-day cricket. Now, captains have come back into focus because there are so many decisions to take. You know, the first 10 overs, how to use the power play, which bowlers to bowl, whether to play spinners up front with a new ball. The Kookaburra ball also swings sometimes. It doesn't reverse now. So you play with 2 balls now. Earlier it used to be 1 ball. So many changes.
The tournament once again returned to England in 1999, with some matches also being held in Scotland, Ireland, Wales and the Netherlands. The tournament featured 12 teams: Australia, England, India, New Zealand, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, South Africa, West Indies, Zimbabwe, Bangladesh, Kenya and Scotland. In the final, Australia outclassed Pakistan to win the title by 9 wickets. ICC World Cup 2003 was hosted jointly by Zimbabwe, Kenya and South Africa. It was the first World Cup being played in Africa. The tournament featured 14 teams, including 10 full member nations and 4 associate members. Led by Sourabh Ganguly, India put up a tremendous show in this edition, reaching the finals for the first time since 1983. But suffered a heartbreak in the final against an all-powerful Australian team that piled a record of 359. In response, India were all out for 234 runs. Australia won the final by 125 runs, defending their World Cup title. The Caribbean Islands hosted the 9th edition of the World Cup. The number of participants were increased to 16. 2 more than previous edition in 2003. Apart from the 10 test playing nations, Canada, Scotland, Netherlands, Ireland and Bermuda also qualified for the tournament. Unfortunately, this edition turned into a tournament of controversies after Bob Woolmer, the Pakistani coach known for his wisdom and experience, died mysteriously in his hotel room. Australia made it a hat-trick of World Cup wins in this edition by beating Sri Lanka by 53 runs via Duckworth-Lewis method in a rain-affected method to lift the trophy. The 10th edition of the World Cup returned to the subcontinent after a span of 15 years, with India, Sri Lanka and Bangladesh playing host. Pakistan were also supposed to host the tournament,
but the ICC decided not to include it after the 2009 terror attack on the Sri Lankan cricket team. Australia lost their final group stage match against Pakistan, ending an unbeaten streak of 35 World Cup matches. India won their second World Cup title by beating Sri Lanka by 6 wickets in the final in Mumbai and became the first country to win the final on the home soil. The 11th edition of the ICC Cricket World Cup was jointly hosted by New Zealand and Australia. The tournament featured 14 teams, the same number as the 2011 edition. In the final, Australia chased down New Zealand's 183 runs with ease and won the final by 7 wickets. With this, the Australian cricket team became the only team in the world cricket to have won the ICC World Cup a record 5 times. This was also the second time that one of the hosts had ended up as a champion of the ICC Cricket World Cup. The Cricket World Cup trophy is not just any other title. Winning the tournament makes the country team a part of the history of the game. The World Cup trophy is made of silver and gold and features a golden globe held up by 3 silver columns that are shaped as stumps and bails. This trophy represents the 3 fundamental aspects of cricket, which are batting, bowling and fielding, while the globe depicts a cricket ball. The current World Cup trophy weighs around 11 kilograms and stands 60 centimeters high. The name of World Cup tournament winners is engraved on the strong hardwood base of the trophy. The current trophy was created for 1999 championships and was the first permanent prize in the tournament's history. The original World Cup trophy with names of all winners inscribed is kept at ICC headquarters in Dubai. Winners of the 10-team tournament earn a purse of $4 million, which is the highest prize money to date. The total prize pot of $10 million will see the runners-up assured of $2 million and the losing semi-finalists $800 each at the end of the 46-day tournament being played across 11 venues from 30th May 2019. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And that's all we have for you in this edition. Thank you for watching.